supper and a mother at the best place around. Some stupid with a flare gun burned the place to the ground. Smoke on the water, fire in the sky. Smoke on the water.
This should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never want to leave. You'll want to sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage
is just for the invited.
Backstage,
they've laid on everything.
Hello, backstage. Da-da-da-da-dam. Yeah, hello, darlings. This is another backstage. Hello, meine Damen und Herren in Österreich, Deutschland und der Schweiz. This is from my this is from my secret place. Yeah, somebody was trying to call me, but I'm not available if I'm with you, of course. Today we are about David Bowie and Queen. Heute geht's David Bowie und Queen. But before that, vorher, and please excuse me, I'm trying to do a little bit of German as well. I will ask you, how are you? I'm a little bit, I have a little bit of a cold, and it's slowly it's getting to me, this whole Corona bullshit, and that we can't do the things that we love to do. Ich sag's auch ein bisschen auf Deutsch. Also ein bisschen, mir geht's nicht ganz so gut heute. Trotzdem werde ich mich bemühen, eine nette Zeit mit Ihnen anzubieten. Aber es ist schön langsam, erst einmal habe ich eine leichte Verkühlung und dann diese ganze Corona-Scheiße geht mir schon langsam wirklich auf die Nerven. Ja? Und all over Europe, all over the world, I mean, we're not talking about America, because also there's also a lot of, everywhere we look, it's lockdown, half lockdown, problem, new virus from England, blah blah blah. So I can only tell you, be more safe. Ich kann Ihnen nur raten, bitte sind Sie noch vorsichtiger. Don't think that this is going to be over soon. No, it's not. I think the whole year is going to be a corona year, to be honest. Vaccine, yes, also important. But please be careful and stay safe and do yourself the favor of of taking care. I mean, I take a mask everywhere I go. Yeah, I leave the room, I leave my apartment, everywhere I go, outside, inside, mask. Yeah, and not 1.5 meters, not 3 feet, but double. Yeah, because there must be new ways of getting it, and it's going to be more and more a problem. I promised you that we talk a little bit about David Bowie and Queen, because as you remember, there was January 8th was his birthday, and unfortunately January 10th he went to heaven. But before that, I want to show you something. Last Sunday, I mean, I posted it, but this is the article. Hang on, it's actually, I have to do it like this. Oops. This is the article, the double page. Oop, here we go. The double page that Norman Schentz was writing, a star journalist. But here, this is like the one thing, you know, this photograph. You probably know this guy, right? But even more important, and I'm very happy, this is a photograph of Ruby and Benny, and it's in the the biggest daily newspaper. It's in relation to the inhabitants. It's an Austrian newspaper that you only can also can read in Germany and Switzerland. But in relation to the Austrian 8 million inhabitants, it's the biggest daily newspaper in the world. Yeah, and on Sunday it's 3 million readers. Very good article, and thank you very much, Norman. Thanks a lot. Basically, because you know, yeah, you know, I was at Christmas. I was in Vienna, and of course, was with my boys. And of course, it's about the Freddie Mercury book. You know all that. In the Freddie Mercury book, of course, there is also more than one chapter about David Bowie, and one important collaboration, as all the Queen fans and Bowie fans know, is of course the song "Under Pressure." Dum 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 doodle dum 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 doodle dum 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 doodle dum 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 doodle dum dum. And although probably the hardcore Queen fans know probably all about this song, I might be able to tell a few things about it. The song was created, of course, in Montreux, Switzerland, in the famous Mountain Studio, where there is a studio experience, which, you know, the Queen productions, Jim Beach and Queen and a lot of other people helped putting together. You also see my photograph in there. Of course, Roger and David, and David Bowie, that is, once told me how this song happened. I mean, Queen was in Montreux. They were jamming, but they didn't really have... it was sort of a jamming a day in the studio. And David Richards, the producer, who unfortunately also went to heaven because he wanted to do more productions with David Bowie, David Richards called David Bowie, because David Richards also worked on Bowie albums. And he was telling him that Freddie, Brian, Roger, and John were in the studio jamming, and wouldn't he like to come and jam? And David said, well, you know, he said, yeah, why not? Yeah. And they came, and as you probably know, the song wasn't called "Under Pressure" in the beginning. No. It was "People on the Streets," diddle-dee-da-dum. "People on the Streets." It was called "People on the Streets." And some of the essential vocals were not done at the moment there. Freddie, as far as I remember, went with Peter Freestone to New York much later and did it. But the basic song was created there. Now, why am I telling you this? David lived nearby. David Bowie lived nearby. I mean, I'm not sure whether you, all of you know that, but why am I telling this? Well, because my contribution, not only that I, of course, filmed David and Freddie and Roger and Brian talking about it in my documentaries like Magic Years or Champions of the World or The Queen Phenomenon. No, much later, I had the privilege to be asked to do the video. Now, let's not mix it up. The original, when the song was released, there was an original video which didn't show the band, which is done by my dear friend David Mallet. There was archive footage of buildings that are collapsing and things like that. That's David Mallet's work. I have nothing to do with that. You know that I respect David, but he also had the disadvantage that at the time it was said that it was the time schedules of Bowie and Queen couldn't be matched, so that they couldn't do a video together where they actually are seen in the video. But when there was done the RAH mix, RAH, quite some time later, I was asked by both, by Queen and by David, to do a proper video. Now, as you probably know, at that time, Freddie was not around anymore. And although I had an even more bigger disadvantage, I think it turned out really interesting, to say the least, because my ambition was to create something in the video which never happened in real life, to create an illusion. And I remembered that Freddie and Queen, as Queen, were performing this song without Bowie in the Wembley Stadium as part of the Magic Tour in 1986. And I filmed also, and I was there. And then at the Freddie Mercury tribute concert, which is this, David was performing that song, but with Annie Lennox. And but they were both on the Wembley Stadium. So the idea was that I create the illusion that they are on stage, but there were quite a few obstacles. And at the time, don't forget, this is quite some time ago. These days with computer, it's easier, but we had to do it frame by frame. You know, as you know, a second in video or film is divided in 24 or 25 single pictures that creates the illusion of a movement. So long story short, I had, number one, to get rid of, frame by frame, which is a lot of work, of Annie Lennox, which wasn't that easy because sometimes she was very close to David. On the other hand, when David was performing under pressure in the Wembley Stadium at the Freddie Mercury tribute concert, it was already evening and dark. When Freddie and Queen were performing under pressure, 1986, it was daylight. So I had to also match that. So it was quite a few things. So there is actually a few shots where this illusion was happening. And when you see the edit, and it's obviously on my YouTube channel, you see that actually the illusion works also with the intro and intercut. So, I also was winning awards all over the world. Here is one of the good Blu-rays, Queen Greatest Video Hits, where quite a few of those videos, it's a gold and platinum awarded, is my work. But on this one, there is the old, original David Mallet video, whereas soon to be on Duopolis, on this one, US music video reel of Rudi Dorletzer, you find quite a lot of interesting videos, including Queen, David Bowie, Under Pressure, RAH mix. So That's going to be, that's basically a showreel, remember? Yeah, I told you that. I have quite a lot of those. There's also Rammstein, Sarah Brightman, of course, Queen, No Mercy, Where Do You Go? Age Blocks, Queen, Fico, Amadeus Amadeus, and a few other great videos from various times of my career and my work. Also, I mean, this is still a very good, it's just, as far as I know, it's never, was never released on Blu-ray. This is a DVD, which also recently received gold and platinum status with a very, very great booklet, as always. Jim Beach masterminded a very, very nice. That was a very, very special evening. I remember that. And what is still a lot of unreleased footage is, here we go. I was allowed to film, the rehearsals. 3 weeks in the Bray Studios near London. And to me, that was even more thrilling than the actual concert, which was great, of course. Yeah, because you saw, David Bowie, Elton John, George Michael, Annie Lennox, The Who, Slash, Guns N' Roses, etc. You saw them relaxed, in regular clothes, rehearsing with Brian, Roger, and usually not John, because he came into that game very late. And it's very, very great memories. Of course, that's also some things that are described in my book. I mean, Lisa Stansfield, Elizabeth Taylor, Paul Young, Zucchero, Mick Ronson, also up there, the guitarist of David Bowie and the Spiders from Mars, Liza Minnelli, Tony Iommi, Ian Hunter, Bob Geldof, Roger Daltrey, a lot of great artists. I was very privileged, and I thank. And it was a concert for AIDS awareness. That's one of my, since Freddie left us, the Mercury Phoenix Trust and all of this AIDS awareness is one of the things that I am really very much still do a lot for, because it's important. Because there's still AIDS is still there. I mean, we all talk about Corona and COVID-19, but people still die of AIDS. We still don't have a cure. We only have medicine that makes your life longer. But Jim Hutton was able to live much longer than Freddie, as you know, although he joined him up there. So don't forget these kind of DVDs and Blu-rays soon to be on Europolis. Of course, if Queen allows it, there will also be stuff like that, and I sign this. There's a great booklet, as far as I remember. In this. Yeah. Yes, the booklets are usually very, very nice. That's, of course, also something classic. And if you look, you also find my name in there quite often. So the Freddie Mercury tribute rehearsals. Now, apart from the Under Pressure video, was also something where David Bowie and I worked together. There is this famous interview backstage where we were also talking about my jackets. But it was also there when David, which was not filmed, but when David told me in the dressing room a lot of things which I, for the first time, revealing my book, My Friend Freddie, because we talked quite a lot there. And I think that David Bowie is one of the outstanding artists as well. I mean, don't get me wrong, my love to Freddie Mercury is unbroken, but David Bowie is, I loved him and I respected him for a lot of things. First of all, he was also a very good painter. Yeah, he was very good in visual arts. He was very good as an actor, I think, very underrated. And he was also somebody that where you could talk about a lot of topics, not only music, although he was a great performer, a great musician, a great composer. So I remember when I filmed the live concert of him with his band Tin Machine, we really got really very close and had a lot of great discussions at that time. So David, I miss David a lot. David is a great artist and will always be. Freddie Mercury tribute concert with David Bowie, then the videos. I even did a video in Mandarin language. Hello. The person knows whom I mean. Hello, Claire, because she speaks Mandarin, my Australian liaison. I did a video with David Bowie because he understood very soon, very early in the game, that there's so many Chinese. Therefore, he re-recorded a song in a Mandarin language, which was really a great idea. One thing I wanted to show you, I have, when I was leaving offices, changing offices, I found this jacket. Now, I'm not gonna put it on because this is today, but I found this jacket which I bought, of course, in Miami, and I was never wearing it. So I thought this is a nice thing for the new Rudy, you know, since I'm no alcohol, a lot of sports, and together with the host shoes. I mean, those shoes, which are, of course, of a very famous designer from Paris, I was wearing them for the Grammys. And for the next Grammy, I'm wearing those shoes and this jacket, okay? So, darlings, I hope you are well. I have to go to bed a little bit because there's a lot of things happening in the moment. There is a super international project with a lot of international superstars that I was asked to do. Then my home country, Austria, asked me for doing something very important. There's also something Queen related. There is my project with Peter Freestone, and I'm also sort of was asked to go back to journalism. Not forget, always, even if in tough times, my Romero Brito friend, love. And it's really tough, but we have to do this together. I will soon do a separate video on the situation in America regarding your democracy, which is something that I don't want to do within Backstage, but watch out, soon I will do, you know, my friend Arnold Schwarzenegger did something with the Conan sword. I don't have a sword, I don't need a sword, I have my language and my words. Sometimes they are as a sword. You know my three wishes, right? Darlings, please, you know the many, many. Yeah, let me tell this in German. Please pre-order my book. Also mit der Vorbestellung meines Buches My Friend Freddy, nachdem das ja in diesem Artikel in der Kronenzeitung sehr, sage ich mal, ausführlich 50 Kapitel mit Tiefgang besprochen wurde. It geht's folgendes. Please excuse me talking English, talking German. I will come back to English soon. Also www.myfriendfreddy.com. ist die Website. Da ist es sehr leicht erklärt. Das ist natürlich Englisch, aber es ist leicht erklärt. Das Buch wird es in 11 Sprachen geben und soll am gleichen Tag auf der ganzen Welt erscheinen. Das ist die Idee. Sie können jetzt schon ein signiertes Exemplar vorbestellen für $10. Das sind umgerechnet 8 Euro oder sowas. Oder für $15, das ist ein bisschen mehr, ein sogenanntes VIP-Package. Da mache ich auch noch eine Widmung hinein, die Sie sich aussuchen können. Sie haben folgende Vorteile, wenn Sie das machen. Erstens, die Leute, die so lieb sind und das jetzt vorbestellen und mich damit unterstützen und damit auch zeigen, dass sie daran glauben, dass das ein gutes Buch wird, die bekommen das Buch als erstes. Wenn das Buch fertig gedruckt ist, bekommen zuerst alle Leute, die vorbestellt haben, bevor es noch zu Amazon geht, bevor es in ein Geschäft geht, bevor es auf irgendwelchen Plattformen verkauft wird, kriegen es die Fans und Freunde und Followers, die jetzt vorbestellen. Punkt 1. Punkt 2, es ist signiert. Und ich weiß, es wird nirgendwo anders signierte Bücher von mir geben, nur auf meiner Homepage. Drittens, Sie bekommen einen goldenen Backstage-Pass zugeschickt, weil ich danach eine Buchtour machen werde, eine Tournee, natürlich auch in Österreich, Deutschland, Schweiz, aber auf der ganzen Welt. Und mit diesem Backstage-Pass, wenn Sie vorbestellt haben, kriegen Sie ein Meet and Greet, das heißt, Sie treffen mich, Sie können Selfies machen und mit mir plaudern. Und dann, um damit das Package noch, wenn es nicht schon so toll wäre, um die Wartezeit zu verkürzen, es wird noch ein bisschen dauern, bis das Buch ausgeliefert wird, mache ich ab Februar Lesungen, Streamings online und nur die Leute, die vorbestellt haben, können die sehen, bekommen einen Code, Zugangscode und nur Leute, die vorbestellt haben, sind da dabei. Also wenn das kein guter Deal ist, wie gesagt, www.myfriendfreddy.com. My English friends, you know that, you know the advantages. If you, most of you who are watching have probably already pre-ordered, but please also tell it to your friends. It is a limited offer and soon it will end. So now, and then we will say, oh my God, it's over now. Now you have to do it now. So pre-order my book. Please, if you go to Rudi Dolitz als Doro TV, like and subscribe my YouTube channel. It's free of charge and without any obligations. And then please, never miss a Sunday Rudi backstage, because Sunday, and I mean every fucking Sunday, it's Rudi backstage. Backstage? Better than television. Thank you very much. And as always, the last word has Freddy. Darlings, until this day, Freddy is the person in all my life that influenced me the most. My mentor, my hero, my friend. This book tells it all. Easy love, but you got friends, you get trust. Friends will be friends when you're in need of love, they give you care and attention. Friends will be friends when you're through with life, but not hope. Freddy was a special person, and I felt very privileged to call him my friend and to work with him and Queen. This book tells it all.
You wanna know what goes on backstage? Oh, come on. Let me take you by the hand. Ow!
Rudi, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
all you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never wanna leave. You'll wanna sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage
is just for the invited.